So over 30 days, we're going to write 30 smart contracts. And yeah, this is day one. I am Sneha from Web3 Compass. And this is day one of 30 days of building with Solidity. And also my first YouTube video. So spare me the horror if I fumble a lot. For everyone who is a part of the campaign, you are already aware of what this campaign is about. For those who have just stumbled upon this video randomly, let me tell you that 30 days of building with Solidity is a campaign for builders who are looking to get started with Web3 journey in general, and what better than learning with Solidity, right? So over 30 days, we're going to write 30 smart contracts. And yeah, this is day one. So if you go on the website web3compass.xyz and click on day one, you will see that the first smart contract that we're going to write is ClickCounter.sol. The concepts that you will master are basic Solidity syntax, variables, increment, decrement functions. And if you look at a example application, it is more of a simple counter contract to learn variable declaration, function creation, and basic arithmetic process. In short, I would just say that imagine a website that just has a button, and every time you click on it, there's a counter that increases by one. So we're not going to go forward with a front-end development or how that integration works. We're just going to implement this in Solidity. So let's just get started, okay? So before we get started with what we're going to do, we will head to Remix IDE. It's an online platform where you can write your Solidity smart contract, test it, and deploy it. Now we're using this so that you don't have to go through the hassle of doing local deployments, downloading 1,000 tools. I mean, not 1,000, but yeah, still, like, installations are scary, come on. So yeah, in my previous recording, I had already like created a file, so I did not delete it. So this file is going to be called as clickcounter.sol. And for everyone, you might have just guessed that .sol is the extension that we use for a Solidity file, okay? Now, let's get started, right? Let's start writing our smart contract. So everyone who is new to the concept, a smart contract is basically a sample computer program which is stored on the blockchain. Once it's out there, it's there just forever, okay? Running exactly as it is written, no edits, no deletions, and it follows the concept of decentralization where, you know, no central authority is actually controlling it. Once it's out there, anybody can just trust the code without relying on other people. No middleman, no misunderstandings, just, you know, clear code, and everything's just implemented out there. So yeah, let's get started. Now this is our Solidity file, and the first that any Solidity code that you open, the first line that you're going to see is a SPDX license identifier. I will write MIT. You can also write, my caps and I don't know. Yeah. So now what is this? Okay, now this in a Solidity file is called license identifier. It clearly tells anyone using your contract that how are they allowed to use it. In our case, because we are writing it as MIT, means anyone is free to use, change, or share the code without asking for any permission. So it's open source. It also means that we are not responsible if someone runs into an issue using our code. And it helps everyone stay very clear on what's allowed, especially since smart contracts are public, okay? Now, okay, next line. Now you can see that the autopilot is already looking at AI tools making our lives easier. It already gives us the next set of, contract. So I'll just still type it so that I have the practice of it and not make a lot of mistakes, because now I'm like multitasking, doing 1,000 things at the same time, recording a video, blah blah blah. Okay, so Pragma Solidity 0.8.0. Now there's I call it as an exponentiation symbol. I don't know the real name of it, if that's not the real name. Now what does it say? So this tells Solidity exactly which version of its compiler the contract was designed for. But why do we need that? Okay, because blockchain is a very, very, not very new, okay, but still in a early stage. Solidity as a programming language undergoes a lot of updates, okay? Sometimes those updates change how the language works. So if we are specifying a version, we ensure that our contract will use versions close to 0.8.0, but never something totally different, okay? And with this exponentiation symbol, we are saying that, hey, any version which is above 0.8.0 is also applicable. That's what it does. Now, what do we do next? Okay, so these two are mandatory lines in the code. If you do not write the license line, you will get a warning. So you have to make sure that you write it. Now we'll get started with the contract. Okay. Contract. Now, what are we trying to write? Since we've called it the click counter, we will just say click counter, okay? So the contract keyword is going to tell the compiler that, hey, the contract has just started. So it officially marks the beginning of your smart contract. Everything that you're going to write between these curly brackets become a part of the click counter contract, and once deployed, it lives forever on the blockchain. So it is important to carefully check your work first. Okay, now, okay, if I tell you that, hey, how are you going to implement it in the back end, like if I don't tell you that how the front end is going to look like, or if I just give you a design of it, that okay, a front end developer is making this button, and all I want is that every time somebody clicks that button, the counter just increases by one, okay? So what is it that you would do? Okay, so for me, I would say, okay, let's just have a counter variable which would store the count of it, and then maybe create a function that would implement that every time a user clicks on it, the counter increases, right? So we'll just hypothetically imagine that there is a button and see how we can do that with Solidity. Okay, so we say, okay, uint 256 public counter. Okay, now what does this mean? So uint 256 stands for unsigned integer, which means it's a positive number including zero, and public here means that anyone can easily view its current value anytime. Okay, because it is stored on the blockchain, the value will not disappear when someone closes or refreshes the browser. And there's a very interesting angle to it, which I will show. If you go to the Solidity compiler and compile the code, as of now, you've been doing everything right, okay? So that is why you do not have an error. Now let's try to deploy it and see what happens. Now, if you go here, you will see that, oh, there's a button, right? And maybe try removing this. Compile again, no errors, and then try deploy again, and you will see, oh, okay, right, there's nothing here. So the public generally sets a getter function by default, so you will be able to call this particular variable to fetch the value, again the getter function aspect. So we'll put the public back, okay, and let's go. Okay, so now that we've declared a counter variable, we need to write a function that would perform the particular operation. That every time that function is called, that means a button is clicked, the counter increases by one. Okay, so for function in Solidity, we use function keyword and let's name it click. Okay, now what happens? Imagine that we don't know what public is. Now you will see that, oh, we're getting a warning here which says no visibility specified. Did you intend to add a public? Okay, so whenever you're writing a function here in Solidity, you're supposed to add a visibility modifier which tells the compiler that, hey, you know, this is where this particular function can be addressed. There are many more which we are going to talk about towards the later days in the campaign. So we'll write public and we'll just say, okay, counter plus plus. Okay, now so this counter, because we've declared it outside the function, it is accessible anywhere in the function, and this is called a state variable. That means that the value is always going to be there on the blockchain. Now there are other concepts of local variables and global variables, but that is a later discussion. A lot more concepts, but let's not get overwhelmed and see what happens here. Okay, is there anything that else we have to do? Now we compile it and everything's working fine. So I'll just deploy it again and it says, okay, let's see. Now because we've created this function, we say, okay, click, and when you click it, there's a transaction that's being recorded here, and boom, you see that, oh, it went through because there's a green check. And then if you say counter, it says one. Okay, if you would have fetched it previously, the counter would be zero. Again, you click it, counter 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's see what is the value, 6. Okay, so that's it. Okay, so this simple function adds one to our counter every time it is called, and public means obviously anyone can use this. Counter plus plus means that we are adding one to the current value. Now every click increases the counter permanently on the blockchain, and since it changes data, there's a tiny fee called gas every time it is used. It's like a like button, each click counts. Okay, so how is it all working together? But before that, the gas thing that I was telling you about, so you will see that, oh, the transaction cost was this, execution cost was this, and the total gas was this. Okay, so yeah, that is the fee that we are talking about. Every transaction will need a cost. Now how is it all working together is that if you look at the smart contract as a whole, you deploy the contract onto the blockchain. Initially, the counter is set to zero. Each time someone calls click, the counter goes up by one. Anyone can check the current value at any moment, and every interaction is recorded permanently on the blockchain. Now, how do we make it even better? Huh? So I hope first that all of these concepts are clear. Once you're done with this, what you can do is, in order to play around with the smart contract, you can just add a reset button to bring the counter back to zero, create a decrease button to lower the counter value. But yeah, that's it. That's it for day one. With this tiny counter contract, you're now familiar with essential Solidity concepts like variables, functions, and permanent storage, like I mentioned, state variable. And you'll soon be building even cooler dApps. So see you.